Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we are going to study two-dimensional and three-dimensional figures. Any image, like a photograph, is two-dimensional. As it has height and width, but no depth, now we can draw figures like circles, triangles, squares, rectangles, etc. on a plain sheet of paper. All these figures have two dimensions, that is height and width, but no depth, so they are called two-dimensional figures. Also, figures like spheres, cubes, cuboids, cylinders, cones, etc. have three dimensions, that are height, width and depth. So these are three-dimensional figures. Thus we have seen that figures having two dimensions, height and width but no depth, are two-dimensional figures. And figures having three dimensions, that is height, width and depth, are three-dimensional figures. Now, a rectangle is a two-dimensional figure as it has length and width only. Suppose you move a vertical rectangle horizontally. This way you will obtain a three-dimensional figure, that is a cuboid, or you can call it a rectangular prism. So a rectangular prism is a three-dimensional figure whose all faces are rectangles, a matchbox is an example of a rectangular prism. Here we have seen that a rectangle is a two-dimensional figure as it has length and breadth only, and when we move a vertical rectangle horizontally, we will obtain a three-dimensional figure, that is a cuboid, which has three dimensions, that is height, depth and width. Similarly, a triangle is a two-dimensional figure . Now if you move a vertical triangle horizontally, you will obtain a three-dimensional figure called a triangular prism. So we obtain a triangular prism, which is a three-dimensional figure. So, a polygon is a two-dimensional figure with more than two sides and a polyhedron is three-dimensional, whose faces are all polygons. There are some figures that are not polygons, like a circle approached by its center. You will obtain a three-dimensional figure called a cylinder. Pipes, cans, etc. are the example of cylinder. If a vertical right triangle is twirled around on its leg, it will form a three-dimensional figure called a cone. This is a vertical right triangle, and if it is twirled around on its leg, it will form a three-dimensional figure called a cone. And hence we obtain a cone, which is a three-dimensional figure. In this manner, we can form many three-dimensional figures with the help of two-dimensional figures. Now we shall discuss front, side, and top view of solids. Imagine an ice cream cone. If you look at the ice cream cone from the front, what do you see? Here, you will not be able to see three-dimensional cones, but the cone will appear to be a triangle only. So, the front side of the cone is a triangle. Similarly, if you see the cone from the side, you will be able to see a triangle only. But if you see the cone from the top, you will see a circle. So, the top view of a cone is a circle. In this way, we can find the front side and top views of solids. In the rectangular prism, the front and top view is same, that is a rectangle. In a rectangular prism, the front and top view is the same, that is a rectangle. So in this session, we have learned some facts about two-dimensional and three-dimensional figures. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.